Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, and today we're going to be reading Mr. Perfect. Look how perfect he is. He's also looking kind of sleepy and cute. Here's Koala.
Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, and today we're going to be reading Mr. Perfect. Let's read about him.
Mr. Perfect, let's start reading. Let's start reading the story about him. Mr. Perfect. It was a perfect summer's day, and on this perfect summer's day, Mr. Perfect was looking even more perfect than usual. He didn't have a hair out of place. Mr. Perfect lived in Tip Top Cottage, and on this perfect summer's day, his house was also looking even more perfect than usual. Not a curtain out of place. I suppose you're wondering why Tip Top Cottage was looking so perfect? I shall tell you, it was Mr. Perfect's birthday, and he was going to have a party. There was a knock at the door. Perfect! Cried Mr. Perfect. How very kind of you, he said when he saw all his guests had brought wonderful looking presents. Please do come in, and if no one minds, we'll open the presents later. Nobody minded in the least. Well, almost nobody. What's that? Roared Mr. Uppity. I didn't have any time to waste, you know. You better make sure we don't get bored today. You think this upset Mr. Perfect? Of course not. Mr. Perfect had perfect manners, unlike rude Mr. Uppity. Oh no, my dear Mr. Uppity. We won't be bored today, he replied. First of all, we shall dance. And everybody danced, even Mr. Uppity. But although he danced, Mr. Uppity couldn't manage his smile. Unfortunately, Mr. Clumsy, being his usual clumsy self, broke a pile of plates. You think this upset Mr. Perfect? Not at all. Don't worry, Mr. Clumsy, said Mr. Perfect. And, being the perfect person he was, and not in the least a bit clumsy, he produced a whole lot more plates made of cardboard. Then he brought in a cake. It was huge. It looked wonderful. It smelled terrific. And Mr. Grady thought it tasted delicious. He gobbled up the whole cake in 3 seconds flat. Wow. There wasn't a crumb left for anybody else. Do you think this upset Mr. Perfect? Not in the least. Being perfect, he already guessed what would happen. Quickly, he brought out lots of small cakes. There were plenty for everybody, even Mr. Perfect. But as he was not greedy, he only ate one. One cake was just perfect for him. Once everything had been eaten, Mr. Perfect opened his presents. He said as many thank yous as there were presents. Well, not quite. What about my present? Cried Mr. Stingy. Mr. Stingy's parcel was so small that Mr. Perfect had not seen it. Mr. Perfect opened a tiny parcel wrapped in newspaper. Oh, Mr. Stingy, said Mr. Perfect, you've given me a lump of coal. How kind of you. It's delightful. If I'd known, I've only given him a half lump, grumbled Mr. Stingy. That's it. I've had enough, cried Mr. Uppity suddenly. I'm fed up with you, Mr. Perfect. And do you know why? I'll tell you. I've discovered that there's the most enormous, unbearable, exasperating fault with you. Would you be so kind as to tell me what that might be? Asked Mr. Perfect, as politely as ever. Don't you understand? Cried Mr. Uppity. Your fault is that you have no faults. What? I don't understand. Bye everyone, hope you like this video, subscribe to my channel, and see you tomorrow. Bye!